Remember the last time you were at the beach? Everything was perfect. The sun was shining, the sand felt warm underneath your feet, the cool ocean just waiting for you. But then you see it, the slimy seaweed barrier between you and the water. Ooh, and did you notice the smell? Let me be clear. It really depends on where we find the seaweed. Usually seaweed grows seasonally, and out in the ocean, it is home to numerous creatures. But with rising temperatures, its growth has become excessive, and more seaweed is washed to the shores every year, causing an environmental and a financial problem. In 2019, $45 million were spent to clean up 15 miles of Miami-Dade beaches. Wouldn't it be nice if we could turn this nasty goop nobody wants to see at the beach into something essential and useful, something we want and need every single day? Actually, we can. When converted into liquid fuel, this seaweed could substitute 10% of our nation's transportation energy demand. If you want for the actual numbers, that's 2,100, 620 million gallons of fuel. We do need some help from tiny microbes though, because in nature, this beautiful seaweed is made to persist. Seaweed is like a thick rope with multiple intertwined strings, making it extremely hard to decompose. It has a super complex structure with a lot of chemical bonds to resist degradation as much as possible. That's why it takes at least 6 months for it to compost. And by that time, the beach season is so over. That's why I am looking for enzymes that break down these tough structures fast. And since our digestive tract is doing a pretty good job at decomposing our food, my search starts in a fish's gut. My challenge is to screen tons of microbes to find expert degraders producing enzymes with just the right kinds of tools. Imagine it as a Swiss Army knife found in a fish's gut. Sometimes you need a larger blade to break down the structures into smaller pieces, so enzymes can tackle the bonds from all ends. And sometimes you need little scissors to fit the tiny gaps in the tightly bonded structure. Once I have identified the successful microbes, I take a closer look at their genetic blueprints to copy their enzymes and eventually reconstruct the Swiss Army knife to repeat their successful solution without the fish. I want you to remember that the highly specific enzymes in a fish's gut do an exceptional job in breaking the tough and resilient structures, and by that allow us to turn seaweed into a multitude of useful products, including renewable fuel. My research aims to fuel your beach vacation. And the next time you're at the beach, remember me and my fish guts and how they can help clean up the shores while filling your tank.